also, because he was the plumber, all he was working, but he wasn't working. Well, I water as much as I could, but the flames, you know, for some reason, they came down and started to burn the fences.
Right.
But it wasn't in seconds. God. But you got your lunch? No.
No, I had a little piece of stuff that I put over to block the light so I can see into the screen better.
Is it in the bag? Camera bag?
So the pig is in with the original owner?
Not anymore. She's at home.
Oh, that's great.
She is. She is very happy to get home.
Oh, yes.
That's her home, not the other place. Yeah, Sylvie was funny. Why don't you just leave her there? Pig didn't want to stay there. She broke out. She broke the gate.
No kidding.
And she was in walking around across the street. She didn't want to stay there. She wanted to come home.
Oh. How big she was when you got it?
She wasn't very little. I mean, she was probably 50 pounds.
Oh.
Are you done now?
Yeah, I want to take over anytime.
I don't need to film. I need to finish setting up my camera for the thing.
Okay, we'll do whatever you want to do.
Do you want to film this or not?
Yeah, I wanted her to film.
Okay, film it.
So finally, you get the cover for that?
Yeah.
The picture cover?
Yeah.
Here, this is Piggy at home.
Oh, she's happy.
First thing she did was went in her little pool. Cute little piggy.
And of course, the fire had to be in the hottest day.
No kidding, it was absolutely horrid. Today was no cool.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty humid.
Yeah, tomorrow morning when we get up and go up, walk up to the drive up. It's like I say, it's from here to that house
mm-hmm.
there. But it's uphill like that. And take some pictures. I mean, now there's just a driveway. It's real steep and goes up. So, and there's no house there.
I don't think the house was that close myself.
What?
I don't think the house was that close to us. It seemed like it was in between there and the tower. A little further behind.
Close enough.
At least the one I was looking at. Maybe you were looking at a different one.
Start to fall,
only one house.
To fly, I mean. Because
well, 18 houses burned, so.
October, when was it? October 13th? We had those fires
all of a sudden. Yeah, it was
October. Flying here, and they even go to the haystack. So we had to come and kill them.
Hmm.
Yeah, the Lambers are sailing through the air, and everything's on fire. Man. We were lucky that they were, because the camp behind this house, there's a canyon like this.
Mm-hmm.
Right, so they had a killer view, I'm sure. I never got to go in that house, but I'm sure they could see halfway to here. I don't know, depends on what rocks are got in the way, but beautiful place. I said, like I said, the driveway was like that, but it wasn't, you couldn't have some old junk car probably make it up the driveway. Couldn't, you could just see the stuff up there. You never were high enough to even see what the yard looked like. Oh my, it's not what it looks like now.
But I never thought Alpine was going to be that prone to fires. This is the second time, isn't it, in about 5 years or so?
Well, no, we haven't had any fires like that since we lived there. We lived there since 2010.
Well, not near you, but in Alpine, yes.
Yeah.
Because I remember they were close to the Hisa Road. And I was working on the Hisa, one of friends of Sylvia's. He has this, he makes pipes for smoking marijuana.
Oh, the glass pipes.
Mm-hmm. All kinds.
Yeah.
And actually he just he assembles, he buys the pipe from all over the world.
Yeah.
And he's multi-millionaire guy. So, when
multi-millionaire makes pipes to smoke out of? That's funny.
Well, he has, I mean, they, when they, before they, the marijuana when
got legal.
Legal?
Yeah.
He was making tons of
money.
Wow. Now he's making more money.
He was selling pot too.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I don't think he did. But he says he never did. But
yeah.
I'm afraid.
Make $1 million making pipes. He left a pile of pipes in the biggest yard. But yeah.
He was so stingy. So I stopped working for him.
That's probably smart.
So I was the only guy who worked with live electricity. He didn't want to turn the electricity off.
Because it turned the lights off.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, he's throwing the pot into it. Yeah.
And because of the factory. So I had to work with the light electricity. But I know how to do it. This is how are you coming to fix this and that? Yes, I will. Are you going to pay me good? I always pay you good. Oh, how good. Very good. Okay, I'll be there. Red is his name. But when those fires hit San Diego, part of his property was on fire. And all the electrical poles were on fire.
Yeah.
So he had to install new poles. And actually the company installed them with just big chopper. And then he came back to put it together. They just, the only thing they had to do was to dig the hole and then to put it together.
Yeah.
It was amazing.
They shut off the power on us.
Oh, yes.
As soon as the fire was getting close to something, they just shut it off.
Well, that's a very good idea, but I mean, you remember that in those years, SDG&E didn't do it.
Yeah.
So they are. They were labeled.
Oh, yeah, malpractice.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And so it was near to $2 million they had to pay.
Mm.
Then, they want us to pay for that. So
yeah.
I don't know the company, are you kidding?
Yeah, I remember seeing it. You know, all those telephone poles and wires, that belongs to them. They have to take care of it.
And they do?
If they want to sell us electricity, we don't own the wires. We're not responsible for the fall down.
And it was negligence. And last night we were to have dinner with a couple of friends of ours who used to live in Mexico. He was the CEO of Procter & Gamble in Mexico. So now his retirement, it's about, he told me that's like $9,000 a month.
How's he going to buy groceries?